Hello! In the previous videos, I have talked about the wedding traditions of India and China. And I hope you are looking forward to this video, because now the time has come to tell you about the rituals of the recalcitrant, unexplored and incomprehensible Russia. Russia is a very large multinational country, but today we will focus on the traditions of Central Russia that have served since ancient Rus. In the past, the groom was not allowed to choose his bride by himself. His parents did instead, and he was able to see his wife only at the celebration. In Russia, there is no such thing as a very long time, but as a reminder of ancient times, a tradition has remained. During the wedding day, the groom should not see his bride before the wedding and is only allowed to do so when taking off the veil. The rite of matchmaking is not as ancient and it has gone out of style quite recently. Firstly, the bride was appointed. The bride's family came to the groom's house and examined the house gold, concluding whether it is suitable for their daughter to live there. If everything was in order and in line with their expectations, the bride's parents accepted the invitation to share the meal with groom's family. In case of refusal, the matchmaking was terminated. After that, the groom, along with his relatives, had to come with gifts to match the girl to her parents' house. During those times, grandmothers, grandfathers, aunts, uncles, parents and children lived in one big house. The guests were invited to enter the house three times, which was supposed to show that the matchmakers were accepted and that their arrival brought joy. Only after the third invitation would the future relatives come in and get now each other exacting gifts. Traditionally, matchmaking began with the words, "You have a product, we have a merchant." After that, each party described all of the adventures of the bride and groom, their families, and then agreed on the wedding. 3 days before the wedding, a bachelorette party was arranged. The bride gathered the woman from the village and invited the witnesser, who sang a sad song which the girl cried. Said goodbye to her carefree years and personal home. Then only the invited woman went into the house and sat on the table, where the drunk wine ate and wept. The bride gave everyone two belts. Then everyone began singing. In the summer they went to the fields, and during the winter they rode, sailed and sang loudly. Then the bride and her friends went to the base house, where they watched her for the upcoming wedding. The groom did not have a bachelor party and went alone to the bathhouse, where he had to be silent all night. Nowadays, not all young couples organize parties, and they pass in the company of friends, merely without tears. On the wedding day at dawn, the bride read prayers in the groom's house, which included various conspirations from the evil eye. After that, she returned to her parents' house, where the groom came for her. This tradition is still honored by many couples. In order to pick up the bride on the way to her house, he had to complete all the tasks from the bride's relatives. Everything was very noisy and fun. He was blocked at the entrance to the village and at the gate of the house. If the groom failed to pass the test, then he had to pay a ransom, with which only a friend witness could help him. The couple was presented with a lot of fillet with rice, from which they had to take a bite and, according to them, omen, the one who bites of more will be the master of the house. After a successful ransom, the symbolic tests, the couple went to church. The groom and his friends were noisy and sad, while the bride went separately on a long journey, without attracting much attention to herself. The groom had to be the first to arrive at the church. In this way, the future wife avoided the stigma of the abandoned bride. Before the ceremony, The bright Mara sprinkled the young with oud and mead, wishing wealth to the future family. During the wedding, the bride and groom were placed on a spread white cloth that was strewn with coins and hopes. After the completion of the wedding, the young had to blow out the candles at the same time in order to die on the same day. Extinguished candles were to be kept throughout their lives, protected from damage, and it for a short time only when the first child was born. Another ritual that is currently popular is the slok, which lovers attach on the day of their holiday at a pre-selected place. The newlyweds should throw out the key, which means that the lock would remain free forever and never open. Just like the new family, it would always be together and never fall apart. The wedding ceremony was carried out in a solemn, cheerful atmosphere. All the neighbors in the village were invited and complete standards could attend and congratulate the couple. The first could last up to 7 days with interportions. Currently, Russian newlyweds are limited to days and invite only relatives, friends and loved ones. The celebration was always very fun, and it included dances, songs, dates, contests for guests and newlyweds. Guests at the wedding should bitter, urging the young to kiss, sweetening order to make the wine sweeter with their kiss. An important but outdated tradition at a wedding is the removal to the veil. They turn on a slow music, and at this time the mother-in-law replaces the bride's veil with a scarf. This means that the girl was switching from the bride to a wife. This means that the girl was switching from a bride to a wife. After the end of the feast, the groom had to bring the bride to his house and carry her in his arms across the threshold. Russians were very superstitious, and it was believed that in this way, evil spirits would not see the bride and bring misfortune. In recent years, Russian couples have often arranged modern European weddings, with ham and steak parties, cutting of cake, throwing a bouquet and garters. Couple love releasing pigeons, symbolizing that the girl is now free from the care of her mother and father and is ready to create a new family, as well as arranging a honeymoon after the wedding. However, some primordially Russian traditions are still being performed. This is all that we would like to share about the wedding traditions Russia. Remember, if you need a wedding film, a video clip or an Instagram video, Nitsky Studio is here to provide you with high-quality editing. Our motivated professional looks forward to working on your project.